Another big piece of the user experience are notifications. Notifications allow you to communicate with the user, and they can take many different forms. Text messages, emails, push notifications, icons, vibrations, banners, and alerts. You'll need to think carefully about how often you notify users and what forms those notifications take, since they contribute to the overall user experience. A graph or matrix like this one can help you think through the importance and urgency of your notifications. As I walk through the upcoming examples, you should think about where notifications might fall in this diagram. In general, you want to avoid sending many messages that have low importance and low urgency. If you're sending a lot of these types of messages, it can make your product feel spammy. Keep in mind that the frequency for a given notification may change over time, and this graph might look different for different personas using the product. You should think about different notifications for different personas as you work on your product. Some might have preferences for one notification over others. In general, there are some key qualities of notifications that you should keep in mind for your users. The first one is control, and it's the most important thing that you want to give users. Little Big Details is a website that showcases a lot of awesome user experience. When it comes to control, Foursquare and Apple gives users lots of control through menus like these. The second is feedback. Other types of notifications involve informing the user about tasks that they are performing. This is really just about good design and user experience. The feedback provided is dependent on the product, and by providing great feedback, you can make users feel like you are looking out for them while making the product more usable. For example, Twitter will try and provide feedback if you send the same tweet twice. Slack, a messaging app, also provides great feedback to users. It provides a confirmation when sending a message to a channel that has people in different time zones. And Amazon provides feedback about whether someone may have bought you an item on your wish list. All of these notifications are related to feedback loops for users to successfully complete tasks. The third is customization. It's a more subtle aspect of notifications for your users. You might do this based on time, task, location, or some other attribute that's tied to the user. Facebook, for example, shows a different part of the world to users depending on the user's location. Finally, you can develop notifications that lead users to form a habit of using your product depending on the frequency and any rewards you might give them. You can tap into what Nir Eyal describes as variable rewards. GitHub provides variable rewards to its users by showing a different octocat each time the user has no new notifications. Tumblr sends emails with playful text when a user follows someone or when someone else follows that user. And Coffee Meets Bagel, which is a dating application, uses digital currency to reward users for tapping into the dating app. Each of these qualities contributes to the user experience and their perception of your product.